or the media mob, as we call them, they're starting to face some reality. Their favorite conspiracy theory is officially dead. Sad day. There's no thrill up people's legs today over at some other networks. Take a look.
Would it be the smoking gun? Would it give information as to criminality? Would it answer the core question of collusion? To the extent that it doesn't, to the extent that there are no more indictments, I have to say, I think it's good news for the White House.
Well, let's be specific. This is really good news for a lot of people around Donald Trump.
That narrative that this was all an elaborate setup, that there was an elaborate piece of the puzzle waiting for that last element, which was Americans colluding with Russians, it clearly is not part of the special counsel's move forward at this point.
So you've been vindicated by them, essentially.
And then he's now vindicated, exactly. But if I'm at Mar-a-Lago with the president, as Pamela's been reporting, the lawyers are...
Feeling good.
That I would be very happy.
You have to say that if it turns out that there is no indictment that alleges any conspiracy between anyone in the Trump campaign and the Russians, that vindicates the president to some degree.
You can see their disappointment. Oh, it's got to be killing them. I can almost taste their tears from here. Years and years of breathless hysteria, lies presented as facts and truth. What is, like, Maddow and all the other MSNBC conspiracy theorists, what are they gonna cover now? What is fake news CNN? Where do they find their content now? What will little Chucky Todd at night be dreaming of? Now, I'm sure, per usual, they'll just find...